Under the preexisting duty rule, a prior contractual obligation generally doesn't qualify as consideration. This rule helps shield a contract from coerced modifications, like a party holding performance hostage for more pay. In Schwartzreich v. Bauman Basch Incorporated, an employer learns that one of its hires is a flight risk after a competitor offers higher pay. The employer agrees to increase the employee's pay, and the parties sign a new agreement, with identical terms except the increased wages. But without additional consideration, is the new agreement enforceable? Bauman Basch Incorporated hired Louis Schwartzreich as a coat designer. In August 1917, the parties signed a one-year agreement to begin in November, which provided a weekly salary of $90. Later, a competitor offered Schwartzreich a higher salary. Bauman, an officer of the company, met with Schwartzreich after hearing of Schwartzreich's plans to leave. Bauman recalled that he offered Schwartzreich $100 per week to stay, because otherwise the company couldn't meet a production deadline. Schwartzreich, however, didn't remember any coercion during the meeting, and recalled that Bauman freely offered the increased pay. Schwartzreich gave Bauman the old contract, and Bauman allegedly remarked that the new contract would take its place. In October, they executed a new contract with identical terms, except for the increased salary. Schwartzreich worked until December and then was discharged, prior to the end of the one-year term. Schwartzreich sued Bauman Basch for breach of contract, seeking damages for lost wages. He claimed that he was due the higher salary of the second contract. Bauman Basch defended on the ground that the second contract lacked consideration. The jury returned a verdict for Schwartzreich. The trial judge set aside the jury's verdict, ruling that there was insufficient evidence that the first contract was rescinded. The appellate term reversed, reinstating the jury's verdict. Bauman Basch appealed.